Deuces.
Whoa.
Welcome to A Cheeky Dose of Football. You're here with myself, Big J.
Cheeky Sport Kim.
It's your boy Troops.
All right, man. And as usual, we're going to be talking about everything crazy that's been happening in the Premier League, in our opinions. And obviously, you guys get to share your opinions as well. All right? First things first, let's get Man United. Let's get Man United out of the way. Because Man United are still sixth.
Still sixth.
While we're recording this, Manchester City... are playing, who they got? Bournemouth away.
Bournemouth away.
So as we talk, as we speak.
Literally as we're filming this. So we don't know what it's going to, we don't know where, if City win, they go second.
Yeah.
At the moment, they're on 49 points.
Yeah.
With Manchester United. Right. So at the moment, it's very close.
You're on 48.
Yeah, that's correct.
Oh yeah, that's correct. Yeah, and you guys are on 50.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. And we're 2 points behind you.
But you're still safe.
So little man, nursery, come back.
It's fine.
They're behind the real club of North London.
All right, so let's talk about Chelsea, Tottenham. Chelsea did draw.
Yeah, to Burnley.
Wow. Why did I say
the Ginger Mourinho?
Who's Ginger?
Sean Dyche, blood.
Where did the Ginger Mourinho
come from?
That's what they call him, blood.
The Ginger Mourinho.
Yeah, Ginger Mourinho. Because he's, I think he's unbeaten in his last 8 home games.
Oh my days!
For me, it looks like a prison screw, blood. Like, you know, you're walking on, like, you know, man, walk on the wing, blood. Like, you see this guy, he's dead.
Yeah.
It's not dinner time, yeah.
Okay, so basically what I wanted to ask you guys, what did you guys think? Do you guys still feel like Chelsea are going to run away with the league?
Yes.
Do you feel like this was a stint?
Yes. No, I don't think they're going to run away with the league. However,
because they were talking like, obviously, that was 10 points.
I still think Arsenal. They're going to win the league.
But us? Yeah. You're having a laugh, bro.
I still think
the bottles on the table, yeah?
What?
Arsenal.
Bottles. Okay, go on.
I still think they're going to win the league, yeah? But the jury will be out on them, yeah, if they lose the next game and the whole pack backs up.
Who is their next game?
Right?
Who's their next game?
To be honest, it doesn't really matter because they drew to Burnley.
No disrespect to Burnley, but anything Liverpool
happen.
Lost at Burnley.
I know, but
we had to do the handballs to get the win. You lot ain't gone there yet.
Okay.
Burnley are good.
On that question, Burnley's like Stoke away now. It's a difficult way to go.
What would you consider, and this is for all of it, whether you're Arsenal fan, Man United fan, whatever, what would you consider an easy game now? If you had to say, I'd love to play them next, who would you say?
Sunderland.
Really?
Palace are water leaking, fam.
At the moment, they're water leaking, fam.
No, but still, because Man United won. I'm glad you're saying it, though.
You know, you might always go to the Selhurst Park, innit?
Yeah, the Jigsport team. That's gotta be a championship team next year, blood. Shout out Jade behind the camera, blood. Palace and Fulham, blood. You get me? Real London derby. Big up Fulham. United beat Watford. Comfortably.
Yeah,
some people were like, oh no, like it's only Watford. But I'm saying that any team these days.
Watford have been a great one.
The truth is, Watford's a toilet club though, man. Sorry.
Yeah, all they know for is
what's
that song you've got, blood?
Time to Dancer.
Nah, he's got one. He's got that old school song when he's got. He's like, the admission's free.
Hey, guys, it's Graham Daly.
Anyway, alright, cool. So basically what I wanted to talk about us as well, yeah, was Liverpool. Mm. They dropped points. I didn't say Liverpool dropped points. Liverpool actually got points. Yeah. Spurs dropped points.
Ha!
They're still second.
So what I wanted to say is, yeah, because I've been arguing about this all day.
Yeah.
Mm. I still think that Liverpool are gonna be in a bad run of form. I don't feel like this. Maybe. Everyone's saying that this game is gonna revitalize them and it's gonna make them come back.
Listen, I told you about money, blood. Send them down with your pigeon stadium.
Yeah,
blood.
But they're above
you. I see in my comment last week about, oh, truth tax, bear wet, get a Tottenham fan on it. Come on now, savage you, blood.
Wait, Lukaku.
But wait. Ooh. Wait, let me think. wait, let me say
because
something.
Because Mane's only been here 2 years.
Wait, let me say something.
It's his second year, yeah. Lukaku is a beast, like.
Let me say something.
Mane!
Lukaku's got more than Mane. At the age Lukaku is now, he's got more goals than certain man, blood. It's only, I think.
No, a lot of
Neymar has got more goals.
Let me say that. Lukaku in 3 years will be one of the best in the world.
You're the Congolese man.
I've been saying.
You're the Congolese man. Big up, man, like Joe Blow.
From when you score a hat trick,
Lukaku's your cousin, man.
From insert out of third to the
team.
Hey! Wait, there's very few people who came to Sir Alex Ferguson.
Lukaku
don't
know that job.
Lukaku. Yeah, Congolese man. But look,
go on.
He's got a hat trick against Sir Alex Ferguson's team, yeah? Mm-hmm. Not many players done that. And he's a West Brom player. Yeah? From that day, I said to Jay, Lukaku's gonna be a guy. He's gonna be a serious player. Yeah? He's one of the best in the world.
No, he did say that.
He will be.
You've been saying that for a very long time.
And as
time's gone on, he's still definitely.
He is. This guy's worth 60 million. Put in a bid now! Mourinho, put in a bid!
60 million for 5 years.
All right, you get the
If Ozil's worth 60, if Ozil's worth 60, then Lukaku, bargain, man.
You got to buy the bargain. Hey,
that's it, bargain. Bargain basically.
No, no, no. Man United wouldn't want to do it.
What? Deal what?
You buy Lukaku, then you sell off Rashford.
Deal. Okay.
What, as if
I leave a throw.
Ramsey in there. Oh, right, we sell you players in a long-term potential.
Let's move on to Arsenal. You guys had Hull City at home. Hull City are difficult.
Yeah, but Marco Silva, obviously you lot went through, but they beat you lot. They beat Liverpool as well.
They're actually quite a tough team to beat, yeah? I know it's a bit of a, it was a,
They're on a run of form. They're nothing special.
I know you wasn't excited about this week's performance from Arsenal.
No, good.
Yeah, I know you actually had a lot to address in regards to Arsenal this weekend.
Yeah.
And I actually wanted to speak to you about that as well.
Yeah.
Because I know everything has been kind of spiraling. I even went to the Arsenal game
with
Cheeky Sport to cover and speak to some of the fans and stuff. And you know what it is, yeah? Even, to be honest with you, even some of the fans which have a lot of love and respect for Wenger are really ready for a change.
Exactly.
You know what I'm trying to say? So a lot of...
It took you a while!
Yeah, but...
The cameraman still wants him in North Ham, bro.
But they got Chris.
They got Chris though, you get me?
And there's
another... You see Chris Salmon, he wants him in. Chris Cameron, he wants him in. He must be a Christian, blood.
You know, like, it was good, but one of the things that I saw you address was about in regards to Kandi.
Yeah, Kandi, the Ham
and stuff like that.
Yeah, he's a blatant Ham Roll, blood. The guy's just a scumbag, man. You know what I mean? Like, disrespectful. How can you come out and say something like that, blood?
That's disrespectful.
You understand that? Like, it just shows you the kind of person a man is, blood. Yeah. Because...
Just for context, let's let the people know at home what we're saying.
Alright, basically, Jason Kandi,
who is a presenter
on Talksport, came out on his show. He's got a dead show because it's on at 12. It's from 10 PM till midnight. So obviously, you're not prime time. Show's dead. That's why you're a side man on Talksport, blood. You get me? So you was a dead footballer as well. You was a lone man. You spent 5 years at Tottenham and played 28 games, blood. You are not serious, yeah? You're not serious in this thing, blood, yeah? You're not serious, fam. I said you were a top 20 pundits, rude boy. You're not even top 50, blood. Yeah?
What did he say?
What he said was people that talk in my manner should not be entitled to an opinion.
Blood and family.
Yeah, and their opinion shouldn't be valid. Understand? So because I don't talk like, oh, hello, darling, I think Arsene Wenger should leave that club. My opinion is not entitled, blood. You understand?
Yeah.
So obviously, I just had to set
that. That's a very.
I've kind of responded.
So what I'm trying to do is like say like, well, if he really wants to have a debate, like, I'm not gonna flip and attack you or nothing, yeah. But if you're man enough, because obviously we met Gary Neville today as well. He came on Arsenal Fan TV. Can't talk a lot about that. But
can't talk
the video will come out. You lot will see that.
About to go down. Wait. Troops, Mo, Claude, DT, and Gary Neville.
You get me? Big up G Nev, man of his word.
Especially after last week.
You get me? Obviously, you don't know, man, after Savage as well.
But obviously,
I've got Savage to this week, blood.
Yeah.
Real talk, it's been Savage, man, fam. Yeah. It's like me against the media right now, man. And I don't know why, fam, because. I'm trying to represent man.
You know what it is, you know what it is.
They're scared, blood.
Like, with Arsenal, it is like a hot topic. You guys are
there's a lot of snobbish fans.
A lot of snobbish fans. They are a good club, you know what I'm trying to say? And sometimes...
I think there's...
The real fans have been pushed out of the club.
Yeah, I think what's happening.
By the ticket prices.
Yeah, yeah.
And the real fans are Wenger up.
Yeah.
Understand?
Yeah.
They want the man that go there and spend £100, £200 in the club shop after a loss.
Yeah.
You understand? I just about go there and buy a program, blood.
Yeah.
That's all I spend. I buy no beer, no food, nothing.
£7 beer.
£5.50 for a double cheeseburger and it's some burnt cheeseburger,
blood.
I bet a chicken connoisseur, blood. They got, hey, DT got some dead burger from flipping Emirates on Saturday, blood. You're an Arsenal fan, blood. You need to go there and do something. Blood. Get that upgrade, blood.
But look, let me get to the thing of this whole issue here with Wenger, yeah? And I know Jay was saying it before, look. I think the reality is, yeah, something that hasn't really been pointed out enough, is, you know, look, if I'm Wenger, I'm sitting here, I love the club, yeah? I'm not gonna listen. Some people are the sort of person that leaves if they say, okay, I'm no longer doing a good job, I've got to go. Other people is sitting down thinking, well, if Kroenke and the board thinks I'm doing well, I'm gonna stay. So because of that, is it the person's fault for carrying on a job? Whether or not he's good or not is irrelevant. He's carrying on the job. No one's got rid of him. Why are you getting at a person who
Wenger said himself he's there to keep the fans happy.
But we're not happy.
No.
Which is basically what he was trying to say. Which I feel like was basically his way of basically saying, you know, if the fans are not happy.
Ian Wright come out and said that he feels that he's going to go. Yeah, that he said. From the time you got man like Ian Wright saying that, bro, you've got to look into
it. So what do you think? They're saying Eddie Howe.
Max and Allegri's right, mate. There's only one Max Allegri.
Do you reckon you can manage Arsenal?
Me? Of course, bro. Come on, fam. Team we have is capable of competing for titles. All it takes is a man with a bit of passion.
So what do you do different?
I'll instill passion into the team.
Done now, passionate guy.
I will have a plan B, blood. Yeah?
Plan B.
I will go to Old Trafford, yeah, and play 4-2-3-1 and open up my team, blood. Yeah?
No way.
You understand? I will change it to 3 at the back, blood. Blindly.
You can't disrespect Wenger thinking he's just sitting there like in his tie and suit and just
sitting
there dreaming about.
I don't know.
Nah, this is the watching like
I think Wenger's hit his ceiling. Top four.
Listen.
Wenger's a great manager. If Wenger was at Everton, quality.
Nah, you're taking the mic now.
Because he could actually get Everton competing for a top four place.
So you're saying he's a top four manager then?
Yeah, 100%. Top four manager.
But wait, hold on. If he wins the treble this season.
He won't though.
No, but if
we can't win the treble anyway.
We could win it. Let's say you won the treble. To say you're the best in Europe and then still want to get rid of your manager doesn't make any sense.
No. Look at Fergie. You leave.
Fergie back.
Look at the Bayern manager. He won the quadruple and still retired.
Yeah, that's true.
Final four. I just want to say, yeah.
Wenger out.
Manchester. We've seen. You can say that after.
Kroenke out. Usman off in.
We've seen Manchester United lose their manager, longest serving manager, and somewhat crumble, for lack of a better word. Right? So, I'm just saying, if Arsenal
Apple crumble. You don't remember that, innit? Make sure you follow the TRM on Instagram, yeah?
I'm just saying that, you know, just be prepared for uncertainty.
I've already said, I'll give you.
Because when you're going 4-4-4, yeah? And you, someone, a fan like yourself, yeah. A dedicated fan who goes week in, week out. Listen, when I go up to OT and we draw and manage travel from London to Manchester,
yeah.
It hurts you. Yeah. So, when you're going
Manchester City, he's going to come back on the M6.
You're going Germany.
I know.
And if you finish 7th,
oh God.
Troops.
Let me say this now, though.
I don't even know. Okay, welcome to the Corner. All right, this is the part of the show where we read out your comments, right? All the best comments that are on there. That is why it's so important to comment, all right? So, first comment.
Because you also get
savage. Yeah, because you also get savage. Alright, first comment, alright, this is from Hugh Wizzy.
My brother, AFC, you're done.
He's a YouTuber as well.
Yeah, that's my jigger blood.
Alright, he says, no offence, but Akeem really doesn't understand.
And even put the timestamp.
Look at that.
Hey, well done for putting the timestamp. Hey, that's complex, you know. That's complex YouTube right there. Hey, listen.
Wizzy, that's why you're my brother, you know. That's why you're my G, you know.
I keep rabbiting on. Look, if I talk rubbish, like I said, look, it's very simple, yeah? What did I talk rubbish about? Come on the show.
Hugh, you get an invitation.
Hugh, you can come anytime, my brother.
Hey, Hugh, you got an invitation. Come to the show. If you don't come to the show, it means, you know what? I'm right. It means that I obviously weren't talking rubbish. Simple. I would say that.
But cool.
Hugh, welcome anytime, yeah? You're welcome.
All right, cool.
You're welcome.
All right. Big up Hugh Wizzy for watching the show as well.
Well done.
That's right? Love still.
Yeah, it is.
Well done on the timestamp as well. That's complex.
Man, we're gonna have one.
Complex.
All right, another comment that we have here by Habibi Curtains.
Habibi Curtains.
Okay, he said, what is this guy on? Talking about you.
Yeah, cool.
Kante is the best player in the Prem. Easy. My G.
My G.
Making sense.
RG.
Easy.
RG.
RG.
He said, the best.
What is he on? Tell him what sniff you're
on. Hey, Curtains, man. What's he on? Habibi Blinds, mate. Whatever your name is, look.
That's Kante, the Curtains.
For you to say easily the best player in the league, man, you definitely been smoking.
He didn't say easy, he just said.
What did he say? Easy. He said easy.
No, like easy.
Oh, easy.
Okay, depends how you said it. Yeah. If he means easily the best player in the league.
But he says easy.
Oh. Yes. I don't know. I don't know about his grammar. He said he called himself a BB Curtain, so I don't know. I don't know what he's on, man. Listen. Check your name back. Come back to us.
Habibi Curtains, thank you for watching the show.
Big up Habibi.
You got caught though, still.
You got fire, blood.
Habibi Curtains. Okay, cool. This is from United Unleashed. That's all these rival fans can say. Sick. We were 10 points off top 4 week 14. Now we're only 2.
Come with the facts.
How many points were Arsenal and Liverpool ahead of us a couple weeks ago? Now they're only 2 and 1 point in front of us. Carry on screaming sick because we will be above that next week.
Exactly.
And defo finishing top 4. In
and a real name, United Unleashed. Unleashed.
Okay.
Number 1. You said you'd be above us this week. Where are you?
Oh, that's this one.
Where are you? Still chilling with Drake. Yeah? About United Unleashed. Coming in and unleash something on your blood. Yeah? About. Keep screaming sick. Guess what? Sick!
All right, man. And that is us from the corner. All right? Thank you. Make sure you leave a comment. All right. Thank you for tuning in to A Cheeky Dose of Football with myself, Big J.
Cheeky Sport Keem.
All right, make sure you subscribe to Cheeky Sport, where we have all of our crazy fan cam videos, and make sure you also subscribe to Troops TV. All right, make sure you subscribe to Grime Daily, GRM Daily,
GRM.
Big up, you get me.
Follow them on all socials. You get me.
Nah, la la.
Hey, don't miss me now. Don't miss me now. You can imagine after man does his team talk, Sharukas.
I want to see the boat.
What just come out?
See me?
I'm a tactician, blood.
Hey, don't.
Give me the Arsenal team now, yeah? I will show you how to
play. Can I say one thing?